So when you started Trail Life, what was the genesis of it? I mean, did you sit down with some guys and say, look, we've got to come up with something that we can send our young men to that we're not worried about?
Once we lost the battle to try to get the Boy Scouts to not change their membership standards, we realized there was thousands, tens of thousands of parents that were following us and people within the program saying, we're done.
Yeah.
This is a violation of principle. They're compromising youth protection by allowing openly gay young people to sleep with other boys. I mean, it's just, it's common sense. We don't sleep boys and girls because they're attracted to each other. I mean, the mission of the Boy Scouts is to prepare young people to make ethical and moral choices throughout their lifetime. That's the stated mission. So we just said, you know what? We need a Christian alternative. And so through 2013, and you were there at the founding,
I
right
was
here in Nashville,
yep,
at our big convention, we were able to launch. We got scoutmasters together. There were hundreds of people, some of the best scoutmasters in the country, said, how can we do this? How can we make it better, Christ-centered, and more character and safer than the Boy Scouts of America?
Let's talk about how does, let's say if there's a parent or maybe a scoutmaster who's frustrated with where the scouts have gone, how do they start a Trail Life organization in their community or their church? Because a lot of churches have bailed on the scouts and said, you know, we can't sponsor this anymore. So there may be some churches that want to get into Trail Life. How do they do it?
It starts with the church because we are a church-centered organization. It's not just here's some space. We want the church leaders to have eyes on, to know, have relationships with the leaders. So we have a safer program, a more secure program. They have to be youth protected training. They have to have sign our statement of faith. So the adults have to go through a rigorous process. And then you need about 3 to 5 adults to start the program. But any church can do it. Any Christian church that is either Catholic, Protestant, or Orthodox church that can sign a Trinitarian statement of faith can engage. And we would love to have them at Trail Life USA. There's a map there showing all the troops and how to sign up.
So I mean, this is unapologetically a Christ church-centered program for young men. But it goes back to the old traditional camping and hiking and tying knots and learning some basic skills of personal responsibility and first aid and all those things that many of us learned when we were Boy Scouts.
Outdoor adventure, leadership, and character building. That's our three main focuses. Mm. And we want to make boys into men. You know, if you go into most scout troops today, sadly say it's a lot of women. But you go into most Trail Life troops, when I go on Tuesday with my young men,
yeah,
there's men everywhere, and they're godly men, and they're able to see and learn from them. And so it's such an amazing experience for me as a father to have other men speaking in my son's life. That's, you can't buy that.
John, I want to thank you for having the courage, the vision to start something that kind of refreshes this idea, what the Scouts were always about for many of us when we grew up and for even our children. And I hope people will check out Trail Life USA.
Well, Governor, I want to give you the official Trail Life handshake.
Oh, okay. Thank you. I was wondering, what do I do?
And the official chairman's patch.
Thank you.
And pin.
Very cool. Thank you very much, John.
Thank you.
I like the handshake. Now, to learn all about Trail Life USA and how you can join or start a chapter in your community or church, visit traillifeusa.com. Traillifeusa.com. It's where you're going to find adventure, character, and leadership.